DM. I know this is my DM. That is DM underscore WS delineation. I will click open, add, close. So this is my DM. First of all, I will analyze the properties. It is not in projected coordinate system, but it is in the geographic, and the unit are in degrees. So our task is to convert this degrees into meters. That means if I see these steps, so these are the steps. So first I have to reproject my DM. In order to reproject, there is an option. You search for reproject. There is a command known as wrap, WARP reproject. I just double click on this. Provide my input layer as DEM, target CRS as WGS84. So I just click on this, uncheck, search for WGS84 UTM43N. Because this area belongs to this portion of India. So for this portion, I will use 43N. If you are living in maybe Madhya Pradesh or Delhi, just click for 44. If you click on 44, you can see this portion has been shifted. So for this present case, I'm just going to use 43N and I will apply 43N this. Okay. I can see this, my UTM is loaded, and I will click run. I can see my reprojected DM has been created successfully. I just analyze the properties. It is in the projected CRS and the unit are in meters. So our next task is to create the fill sink. So this is my red next task, that is fill sink, that is remove spikes with the help of Wang and Liu algorithm. So how to search for it? You just type fill, F-I-L-L space sink. There is number of algorithms. I just check for fill sinks, Wang and Liu, double click. The DM will be the reprojected one. And the slope will be as it is. And I just need the fill DM. That's why I'll just check this and I will uncheck all the remaining data set. We'll click on run. You can see a fill DM, a fill DM has been created successfully. Please check the properties of this also. This is the projected CRS and the unit are in meters. So our next task is to calculate the stream order or the stellar order. So how to do that? You just search for stellar order, S-T-R-A-H. So here you can see this stellar order. Just double click on this. Here the elevation will be provided of filled DM. And just put the stream order as it is. And I just check this open output file. I will click run. You can see this raster has been created, my stream order. Okay, if you have analyzed this, this is just like a river is going to stream downstream, downstream. And if you want to check this pixel value, there is an option of this identify tool. You just click on this and just click on this random pixel. The value is coming 10. That means the highest the order is, the main the drainage is. If I click on this, the small tributary, the value is coming 7. If I click on this blank portion, that means the value is 1. So this is not the part of any drainage. Okay. So this is my main drainage. So the next task is to extracting the latitude longitude. And in order to extract the latitude longitude, the most easiest method is to create a point. So my task is supposed to create the watershed at this particular area. This particular area. So I will go to the layer, create layer, new shape file. I just create my shapefile as outlet 3. It is will shapefile. Save. The geometry type will be the point, and the CRS will be the UTM. So I just click on select CRS, search for WGS 84 UTM 43N. I just click 43N. This portion will be highlighted. I will click OK, and by other things I will remain as it is. Okay. So you can see this UTM outlet 3 data has been created, file has been created, but there is no data. So I have to create the data. For that, I just put the toggle editing mode on. And here you can see this is an option of add point. So I just click on this and add a point here, because I want to delineate the watershed up to this outlet point. So I just click here and I will give any ID like 1. Okay. Save. Now I want to extract the latitude longitude, and how to do that? You just go to the attribute table and search for this open field calculator. I just open field calculator. I will create a new field with the name of longitude, or you can say it X. I will put it as decimal, and in a geometry column, I will search for $X. So this is my $X, that is longitude. You can see the longitude is highlighted. Okay. The longitude is can be seen here. Now I will add the latitude by the same step, open field calculator. Now this will be the latitude, also known as Y. This will be also the decimal. Now I will go to the geometry and I will search for $Y. Double click on this. This is the $Y, that is latitude. Just click on OK. So I can see that my latitude and longitude of this particular point has been given. I just click save, and I will copy my latitude and longitude in a notepad. Copy. Please remember that this is my X and this is my Y. So I just put the toggle editing mode off, close. Now my next task is to calculate the up slope area, UPSL, up slope area, sorry. SUPSLOP. Here you can find an algorithm known as upslope area. Just double click on this. So in the target area, you just leave it blank. In the X coordinate, I will just copy my X coordinate in this. And in the Y coordinate, I'll just copy my Y coordinate. And in the elevations, I will provide my fill DM, because it is both projected and all these sinks and spikes has been removed with the help of Wang and Liu algorithm. So this is the fill DM which will provide it under the elevation. The method, for example, we can select a deterministic 8. All other thing will be remain as it is. I want to create this temporary file. I will click on run. So I can see this raster has been created known as upslope area. I just zoom to layer. So this time my watershed has been some different, because previously my outlet boundary of my outlet point was there somewhere above. If I check like add layer, add vector layer. So previously you can see this is what my previous point, that's why the upslope area is like this. But now the my outlet point is at this point. So my upslope area, the watershed boundary will be somewhat less. So the next task is to convert this raster into the vector format. And how to do that? You just type for raster to vector. There is a command known as polygonize raster to vector. Just double click on this. You will provide the input layer, the upslope area, and everything will be remain as it is. Just click on run. You can see a vector file has been created which has two polygon. If we analyze the attribute table, there is just two polygon, the outside one and the inside one. So I want to delete the outside one. What I will do, I just select this. First of all, I will put the toggle editing mode on. I will select this and I will click the delete button and I will save it, put the toggle editing mode off. Okay, now I want to calculate the area of this particular watershed, and how to do that? You just simply go to the open field calculator, create a new field known as area. By default, it will give in the meter square, but I want to calculate it in the square kilometer or the meter. So I just give the name and I will provide the decimal numbers. And to calculate the area, just search for the geometry. And there is a command known as option dollar area. I just double click on this. You can see the area has been highlighted in the meter square. So if I want to convert into kilometer square, I just divide this value by 10 to the power 6. You can see it is 61.515. Okay. Now my area has been given in this 61.51. Now your watershed has been created successfully.